Hello friends, today we will start the problem related to general transformation. So the question is, rotate line AB about its midpoint through 90 degree counterclockwise. Means a line has been given which is to be rotated, about its midpoint, means a line which will have some midpoint. We have to rotate that line about that midpoint by 90 degree counterclockwise. Okay, so we have to rotate the line about midpoint by 90 degree counterclockwise, and we have to find final position of that line. We have to find final position, and initial position is given as A minus 3, 8 and B minus 11, and B is given as 11, minus 9. So the coordinates of A and B has been given. So first of all, we will plot this line AB on a graph. So we will plot line AB. A is minus 3, 8. So x coordinate is minus 3, it will come somewhere here, and y coordinate is 8, so somewhere here, means line A will come somewhere here. And now B is 11, minus 9, so another end is 11, means x coordinate is 11, means it will come somewhere here, and the y coordinate is minus 9, so it will come somewhere else. So after enlarging, it will come here. So this is the second point, that is B. Now we will join this line AB. So this is the line AB which is to be rotated about its midpoint, and the rotation will be 90 degree counterclockwise. So first of all, we have to find the midpoint of this line AB. So the formula for calculating midpoint of line AB is, this is the formula for calculating midpoint of line. So formula is x1 plus x2 by 2 for x coordinate, and y1 plus y2 by 2 for y coordinate. So we have to add both x coordinates of line to get x coordinate of midpoint, and we have to add y coordinates and divide by 2 to get y coordinates of midpoint. So we will calculate the midpoint of line AB, which we will get as m x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So here x1 is minus 3 and y1 is 11. So x1 is minus 3 and x2 is 11, and we will divide by 2. Similarly, for y coordinate, 8 minus 9 divided by 2. So the value will be minus 3 plus 11, means it will be 8, and 8 minus 9, that is minus 1 by 2. So the value of midpoint is 4, minus 0.5. So the x and y coordinate of m has been found out, which is 4, minus 0.5. So the x coordinate of m is 4, so I will plot the x coordinate of m, which is 4, means it will come here, and y coordinate is minus 0.5. So y coordinate is minus 0.5 means it will come somewhere here, means 4 and half of 2 is this, here is minus 1, which it will come somewhere here. So the m will be somewhere here, whose coordinate is 4 comma minus 0.5. So the midpoint has been found out. So we have to rotate the line AB about this midpoint by how much? 90 degree counterclockwise. So means we have to rotate. So we all know that rotating any line or rotating any object, first of all we have to bring that object to origin. So here the midpoint is to be rotated. For that case we have to bring midpoint to origin. So first and foremost thing is we have to bring the midpoint, that is M, to origin. For that we have to do translation transformation. So we will first we'll do translation transformation. So the first I will directly write solution. So first transformation is translation. Means translating M to origin. So we are translating midpoint M to origin. So for the standard translation matrix is T equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, Tx, Ty, 1. So for solving the matrix for translation, we will require Tx and Ty, that is translation along x direction and translation along y direction. So we will require Tx and Ty. The first of all, we will see the coordinates of midpoint, that is this one. The coordinates of midpoint is 4 and minus 0.5. For bringing this point to this origin, that is 0 axis, we will require to move the through x coordinate from right to left. So I will move from in this direction, that is from right to left. In that case we have to move 4 units from right to left. Since we are moving from right to left, the sign is minus 4. Similarly it is minus 0.5, means minus 0.5 somewhere here, means we will require Ty also. So for reaching the origin we have to move from downward direction to upward direction by 0.5 units. So Ty is given. Since we are moving from downward direction to upward direction, the sign convention is positive. So Tx is minus 4 and Ty is positive 0.5. So I will write the value of Tx and Ty as minus 4 and positive 0.5. So after replacing the value of Tx and Ty, I get the corresponding matrix as so Tx is minus 4, Ty is 0.5 and last is 1. So this is the translation matrix for the given problem. Now the figure will look somewhere like this one. So I will plot in rough way. Okay. So this is the line. We have performed translation so that we will bring, we brought this M to origin, and this is line AB. So up till now we reached here. Now since we brought the midpoint M, and in the problem it is given as rotate a line about its midpoint by 90 degree counterclockwise, means now we can easily rotate that line about its midpoint. For that we will require theta. So now we will do rotation matrix. So next is rotation transformation. So for rotation, so we have to do rotation. So we have to rotate a line about its midpoint by 90 degree clockwise, means theta is given, which is 90 degree. we have to rotate by counterclockwise. Means anticlockwise rotation has been given. It is counterclockwise. So for that, the sign convention will be positive. So we have to rotate theta by positive 90. And standard rotation matrix is given as R equal to cos theta, sin theta, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is the standard rotation matrix. After replacing the value of theta as 90, we get as cos 90 is 0, sin 90 is 1, is 0, sin 90 is 1, and since it is minus, it will become minus 1. Cos 90 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is the matrix for rotation. Means after rotating the line, the figure will be looked as so now the figure is like this after rotating that line. Now since the midpoint was having some reference point, that is it was having some arbitrary point, so we have to place that midpoint back to its original position. For that we will require back translation, so we have to do translation once again. Third is translation. So back translating, M means we have to back translate M to the original position. So the we all know the standard translation matrix as T equal to 1 0 0 0 1 0 TX TY 1. We will require the TX and TY value. We have to write just opposite to that of translation which we have done in first, that is since we are doing two translation in this problem, so I will represent the first translation as T1, okay, and second translation, that is back translation, I will give the name as T2. So the value for Tx, there we took minus 4, then here we will take positive 4, and Ty, there we took positive 0.5 and here we will take negative 0.5, just opposite to that of T1. So the after replacing the value of Tx and Ty, we will get the corresponding matrices as 1 0 0 0 1 0 4, Tx is 4, Ty is minus 0.5 and 1. So this is the matrix for translation, that is T2. Now we will require Tr. We have to find total resultant transformation. So for that we will multiply all the matrices in the order which is given, which we have solved. So Tr, first we have done translation, that is T1, then we have done rotation R, and afterwards we have done T2, that is back translation. So we will write all the matrices. So T1 was 1 0 0 0 1 0 and it was minus 4.51, and the rotation matrix was 0 1 0 minus 1 0 0 0 0 1. And now writing the matrices for T2 as 1 0 0, just opposite to this one, 0 1 0 4 minus 0.5 1. So now I will multiply all these matrices so that I will get resultant transformation. So multiplying all these matrices, the final resultant transformation I will get as TR is equal to 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 3.5, minus 4.5, 1. This is the resultant transformation which we got after multiplying all the matrices. But in the problem, he asked, find the final position. Means we have to find the final position of the line. For that, we have the formula for finding final position. Final position is equal to initial position into TR. Means we have to multiply the initial position with TR so that I will get the final position of the line. So I will find the final position of the line. Since the initial position of A and B, means the coordinates were given as for A as minus 3, 8 and B 11, minus 9. This was the coordinates which was given. So for that I will have to convert this coordinate form into matrix form. So final position . So since it is a line, so the order will be of 2 by 3. The x coordinate of A is minus 3 and y coordinate of A is 8. And we have to write 1. And x coordinate of B is 11. So I will write 11 here. And y coordinate is minus 9. So I will write minus 9 is 1. And I will multiply it with the total transformation which I have got. So the total transformation was 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 3.5, minus 4.5, 1. So after multiplying this, I will get the final position. So after multiplying these two matrices, the final position of line I got as 8' as minus 4.5 and minus 7.5, and B' as 12.5 and 6.5. Means the final position which I am representing in dash, so final position of line, it is A' as minus 4.5 comma minus 7.5 and B' as 12.5 and 6.5. We have found the final position. Now we will plot this final position so that I will come to know how the line has been rotated, how it appears. So I will go back to the graph which I have plotted for initial position. So the final position in this A' was found down as minus 4.5, minus 7.5. So minus 4.5 and 7.5, both are negative, means it will appear somewhere here. Minus 4.5 will be here and 7.5 will be here, means it will be somewhere here. So A dash is here and B dash I got as continuation of problem number 5. So now I will plot B dash. So B dash I got as 12.5 and 6.5. So 12.5 means x coordinate is 12.5, means here 13. So 12.5 will somewhat here, and y coordinate is 6.5, means it will come somewhere here. So B dash is here. So I will join A dash and B dash. So this is the final position of line which I am represented in dash form, and this is the initial. Okay, so the rotation has been done according to the transformation which we required. Thank you.